What's up, guys? We're back working on this 4G 6.3 cylinder head today. I'll show you the deck surface after we got it welded up. I left it in the oven to cool overnight. First thing we're gonna do after that is I'm gonna pull three of the valve guides out. Three of them are worn out up beyond spec. We're gonna put three new ones in. We're gonna set all the valve guides to the right height. That is important when going to a higher lift cam, and these cylinder heads, the retainer will run into the top of the valve stem seal when it's all together with a higher lift cam. So we're gonna set all those. We're gonna move on to the valve job after that. Check it out. Film the installation of the guides because the camera died. Unfortunately, I didn't catch it till after the fact. So here I'm sizing the guides. The installation of the guide is literally the reverse of the removal process. The tool is kind of cool. It's just got an adjustable stop, so you can just basically put them in there, adjust your stop to the right height, and confirm, and then you're good to go. Here I'm setting the tooling up for the valve job. This is what shows you where the seat is supposed to be on the valve, and then you lay that same pointer without changing it over to the actual seat cutter. We're going into leveling the cylinder head here now. You got to level each guide individually when you cut the seat, in both directions, obviously. I want you to listen to how you hear it clean up. You'll hear it cut. It'll sound like it's not level, and then it'll clean up eventually. That's pretty typical of how the valve job goes, so just listen. That our tooling setup was correct. It's just like a little abrasive compound. You scrub the valve in on the seat, and then it will leave a line on the valve where the seat actually is, as you can see here once I wipe it off. So the gray, the dull part, is the actual seat contact on the surface. I know the picture isn't that focused real well, but you get the idea. I'll run through the rest of these, doing all of the others of the exhaust side here. I'm going to measure the valve, which if you know the 4Gs, you realize that that's actually an exhaust valve, not an intake valve I'm measuring, but you get the idea. This is a cutter to set the throat diameter. Now, you want the throat size to be a specific percentage of the overall valve size. And on the intake side, we have to cut them. The exhaust side is pretty close out of the box. So this is the tooling I'm set up to cutting that. It is a live pilot, so the tooling is a little bit different than the valve job tooling, but accomplishes a similar task in the end. On the intake side, we're going to reset our tooling up and do the valve job on the intake side as well. Alright guys, we got the valve guides all done and in, unfixed, all that stuff's done, they're sized correctly. We got the valve job done. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to move on to cutting that, drilling the head bolt holes out. Remember, this is a half inch stud block, this one specifically. So we're going to cut these out to use the half inch stud. I'm also going to do a little bit of die grinder work to the oil drains on this from the deck side while it's in this machine. It's just convenient. So I'm going to get those two things done. We're going to pull this thing out of here after that and get going on the port work. I leveled the deck in both directions. That just ensures that the holes stay perpendicular to the deck in every direction. isn't something I do typically. It's mostly just when there's a lot of casting flash. Sometimes a lot of casting flash builds up in these oil drains, and then we just remove the casting flash, which is all I'm doing here.
Alright guys, if you want to see a video on the basic support work that I put together, check this video out up here. If you missed the first video of the cylinder head, when we got it, we cleaned it, we repaired some exhaust stud damage, and we surfaced the exhaust planes, check this video out down here. Moving forward with this, now that we've got it converted to a half inch stud, we've got the valve guide issue solved, and we've got the valve job done, and the next step is going to be doing port work. So look forward to a video I'm going to do about porting this cylinder head, and then the next steps after that.